What's going on, guys? Welcome back to American Truck Simulator. My name is Moose78. You can call me Jason, though. This is my ATS Let's Play series, Stories on the Road. Hope you guys are doing well today, by the way. And something a little bit different today, using the Mac Pinnacle, which that's not too different. I've used that a few times before now, back when I was in the beta state. But one thing I don't do a whole lot of on the channel is go with a day cab variant of any truck. So that's what we're going to do today. We're picking up that container over there. It is a contracted run. Just going to run it down, a quick little run down to Tucson. Move on over here, get hooked up, and get going. Definitely like how Robert finished this truck off. Really cool, looks really good. I definitely enjoyed using it in the beta state, and I look forward to using it now that it's fully released. That's just kind of weird looking back there and not seeing a sleeper. Dropping down in a hole there. Oh, there we go. So I thought I was pretty much spot on there. Looks pretty good, I think. I think this thing will definitely make a good cane hauler. For sure, for sure. Get our HUD back up there and head south to Tucson. I only got, I can't remember what model number it is for the engine, but it's only a 425 horsepower engine. Want something a little bit smaller that you know you would probably find in a day cab. I did install a DP's traffic mod the other day, so we're gonna see how that does for us today. And it actually looks like it's trying to rain. It's not rained on me in game for quite a while, so this will be interesting. Be a nice little change of pace. And the wipers are working now. I know they weren't working in the beta state, but it's good to see they're working now. We're definitely gonna need them today. And maybe, just maybe, we can get out of here today. Busy, busy day here in Flagstaff, I guess. That car is flying up around the corner there. Thought we had an opportunity there, but guess not. Man. Traffic is unrelenting. Looks like we might have an opportunity here. I don't know, I'm gonna be that guy and kind of block traffic there for a bit. Go, dude, go. It was either that or he was sitting there quite a while. Whoops. That's a great way to start an episode, hit a cop. Okay, it looks like the, for whatever reason, whenever it rains, it's not, the wipers are working, but the rain's not coming off the windshield there, so that'll be a bit of a challenge for us, but that's okay. That is okay. Does seem like traffic is a little bit heavier now, though. So I guess that's kind of a nice thing. Does seem like it takes forever to get out from these intersections, though. I have noticed that. Well, that's gotta suck. Convertible in the rain. No bueno. No bueno. Punch it. You got a Mustang. Go, go. Gots to get this stuff to Tucson. Go for it. There you go. There you go. Pretty nice engine sound, though, I gotta say that. See, I can't remember the last time it's rained on me in game. I thought I had the slider turned like all the way down just so it wouldn't, but yeah, what do you do? Be something a little bit different, at least to start out. It's kind of nice mixing up with the day cab too, so. What the frig almighty. Whoo! Alright, well, we're off to a banging start today. I'm coming over, dude. Looks like the rain is gonna let up for us, so that's good. You can see what we're doing now. Man, had that been real life, man, that would have been ugly. Wet pavement coming to a dead stop like that? No good. No good at all. be kind of nice if they added some kind of physics or whatever in the game like that, where, you know, if it starts to rain or snow or whatever, you know, the road gets a little bit slick, makes it a little bit more challenging to drive on. I gotta say, though, early on, I'm kind of liking this traffic mod. Changed it up just enough. You know, it's not too crazy. Cars do merge over a little bit faster. We're just kind of blowing our doors off. I just figured we'd take a quick run today, try to knock it out in one shot. Plus, that's a little bit more realistic, you know, with the day cab, just kind of make it a day run. Kind of one thing that'd be cool if they could somehow add it into the game, you know, if they ever actually add a trailer ownership, is some kind of LTL, you know, freight system. That would be really cool. You know, that, you know, instead of just, you know, taking a truckload of stuff to one spot, you have, you know, say, for example, 5 deliveries you gotta make within a week. Or, you know, 10 deliveries, 15 deliveries, whatever the number is. You know, like on a first day of the week, you gotta make 3 deliveries to, you know, certain places. Then you gotta go somewhere else, make a couple more deliveries. And your trailer, you know, obviously would just get lighter and lighter the more deliveries you made. I think that'd be kind of cool. I gotta figure that inspector thing out, though. Why that gets bright and does that. I don't know, way back in the day, you know, long before the KTI days, back when I was in TTI, Transpoint Trucking Incorporated, going way back there, we kind of did something like that a little bit. I was the contract manager there, if you will, and I would set up, you know, hey, we gotta deliver, you know, 10 loads of frozen food to Eddie's and, you know, wherever, and the guys would have to go to the job board, you know, pick a load and go do it and all that stuff. You know, pretty much just like the external contracts in game now. Yeah, the LTL freight thing I think would be kind of cool. And it's that's something I can probably roleplay in my Stories from the Road Let's Play series. That might be something I start doing. If I can get that... get it to where I can have like a certain trailer be able to pick up cargo at pretty much every company in the game, you know, pick it up and deliver it there. I think that would be pretty cool. Nice thing about the contractor runs, I don't have to worry about setting my speed, my cruise control. Just hammer down at 65. Or as much you can hammer down at 65, I guess. Thank you. tracks here sounds really good too. Traffic is definitely a lot heavier than in the vanilla game. Definitely makes it feel a little bit more realistic, that's for sure. I think this mod just might stay in. Gotta do that every once in a while. I'll just hop out to the exterior view and back into the interior view real quick to get rid of that super, super brightness. Kinda cool looking back there, seeing the trailer. Definitely gotta be a lot more alert for the cars now, that's for sure. Oh, did I miss my frickin' turn? Son of a gun. Son of a gun. Car gonna pass me on the frickin' ramp? Looked like he was wanting to. Paying more attention to looking around truck and everything than I was around there. Let's see. Should be able to turn around here. Not a huge deal. Not a huge deal. As long as we don't have to sit at another intersection forever and a day. Behind this guy. Let's not do this. Let's not stop on this hill. If we cannot do that, that'd be great. Before I was on, just make sure we get out there. go. See how far we got there. We're not too far. Should be able to knock it out all in one run. Not a problem. Probably be a little bit quicker if I wouldn't, miss exits and stuff like that. I probably would have shaved off some time, I guess. And Yule out there in the middle lane just kind of putting along. Where'd that come from? Man, I gotta be on my game here, I gotta be on my toes. I do kind of like that traffic mod though. That is pretty cool. Makes it a lot more, a little bit more realistic, I guess. Just in that you gotta be a lot more aware of AI. Definitely want to hurry up and get this thing down there because I'm looking over there at the sleep meter or whatever you want to call it, and it's getting awful blue. Definitely something I'd like to do a little bit more of. Grab a day cab, grab a quick run, like from the contract market or whatever. I think it'd be pretty fun. Because, now even the short runs take a little bit of time. Getting a little bit sketchy up there. Gonna keep my distance a little bit. Kinda stay in my own lane a little bit. Seriously, come on now. Maybe I don't have to get off on that exit. Okay, good. First, when I looked at that, I thought I had to get off on the exit there. That'd be this one. All right. that's kind of nice. Not so much that. Definitely gotta watch ourselves as a cop up there. We're just about to the destination, all right. Probably could have went down one intersection there, but that's okay. Pretty cool over there, never really noticed that before. Looks like a nice little park or something. Should just be, what, right over... right over there. Yes, love delivering to these this style of Plaster and Sons. And nice thing about it being a contracted run, we don't have to stop and go through all that nonsense, which I could probably set it to just like an automatic parking difficulty, and that way I don't have to do that anyway, which I might do that. Might just do that moving forward. That way I don't have to go into the screen, see where they want to park, just set it to an automatic difficulty and go about it that way. Let's see, right over there. Right in. I'm looking for the flags, but I'm not seeing them. I'm gonna assume it's inside the big shed here. Clear that lumber back there. Just gonna hop out here real quick. Okay, am I missing something or? And I see it flashing on the map there, but I'm not seeing. And either back there in that big shed or inside the building is the only two places I have ever dropped at. When I've delivered to these places. And unless... See, I didn't think I had to. Maybe, I don't know. Maybe I'm losing my mind. Okay, yeah. See, we'll just go back around the building, I guess. Probably, maybe, take a shortcut. Yeah, this is pretty legit. I guess rather than go around the whole building again. I think I am going to do that though. Get that set up to where I can just have it automatically set to a parking difficulty and I guess pull into a place and deliver the load without having to go through that little animation. Go, that should be pretty spot on. And there we go. Alright guys, well that's going to wrap it up on our episode of Stories in the Road. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If so, just give it a like and a share. It just helps me out a bunch and helps this channel grow. And if you're new to the channel and are not already subscribed, please take a look around, watch a couple videos, and consider subscribing now. And guys, until the next video, stay safe out there, take care, and we'll be seeing you.